Hi there. In this video, I'm going to show you how to think about Mixpanel versus Google Analytics, the pros and cons of each, and which one makes sense for your company. And by the end of this video, I'll show you use cases for each one, help you understand the pricing, which can be quite different, and how to make the right choice for your company. And as a bonus, if you stick all the way to the end, I'll show you my ideal setup on how I would actually recommend to clients use these tools together. So let's jump right in. My name is Ruben, and I'm a data strategist that has worked with over 70 plus companies now across 5 continents, and it really spans the entire data lifecycle, all the way from strategy through tool selection, technology design, implementation, training of the people who are actually going to be using the data, and then of course working with the data to find insights. And in some cases, even going all the way to more advanced techniques like machine learning and AI. Now in this video, we'll cover 2 popular tools, Mixpanel, Google Analytics. Mixpanel being a product analytics tool, and Google Analytics being a more multi-purpose, but kind of leans towards the marketing attribution portion. So let's hop in, and I'm gonna walk you through my computer, show you a few things, how to think about these 2 tools, and what's sort of the right choice for your company. So let's start with Mixpanel here. This is the classic insights report or segmentation where we can take events and we can just break them down. So we can take an event and we can see how many times that event happened over last 30 days. We could slice it and see the different segments of that event. And of course, we can combine events in multiple combinations. This is probably the first report you use in Mixpanel. It's very popular and it really gets at the core of what Mixpanel is. You know, it's event-driven. So we have events, and those are really actions that our users take. And then with those events, we can then create different reports, get different answers. So we might see, we might want to know how many signups took place over the last 30 days, or we might want to know where the drop-off is from step 1 to step 5, which would be a funnel. Or we might want to know how many users sign up and then actually come back and use our product. And all of these questions get to really what Mixpanel was designed for, which is answering product-related questions. Typically, these are digital products, so it might be a software like a web app or a mobile app. Maybe e-commerce sites could benefit from this. And even though there's quite a bit of companies that are geared more towards technology, it's still very much for digital companies. So if that's the case, you're in the right place. Now, Google Analytics, on the other hand, has been around for much longer. And it was designed for marketing attribution. So you take your marketing traffic and you slice it, right? You know, the classic sort of Google Analytics report is something like this, where we can see the breakdown of the different channels, whether it's organic, direct, referral, paid ads, doesn't matter. And then we can see how many conversions took place. In this case, we're looking at e-commerce transactions here, but it could be any kind of conversion. It could be a sign up, it can be a download of a PDF, whatever it is. So Google Analytics, or the original Urchin, really came up with this idea of UTM parameters and things like that. And a lot of the other reports are kind of meant to support that. You know, we can see landing pages, we can see session time, pages per session, bounce rate. They're all sort of related to this idea of where's the traffic coming from, where are users coming from, and what do they do once they get there. Right. There is some similarities here to Mixpanel. You know, we have retention reports, there's a funnel report, but not as fully fleshed out, which is where we start to see the first difference between these 2 tools. So really, GA is great for almost any company, especially if they have a website, as almost every company does these days. But it's not as well suited for product-related questions. We could build a funnel here and get some of those same answers from Mixpanel, but it's just more complex. It's not as easy or as nice to do as what we can do in Mixpanel. Same with retention, the cohort analysis, we can do it. It's just not the same. Now, if you're talking about marketing attribution, traffic analysis, Mixpanel is also not very good at that. So we would, we would kind of have to hack Mixpanel a little bit to get that last touch and first touch. And then even then, it doesn't work as nicely as GA. So you sort of see 2 different camps coming up. Now, the first thing that comes up with GA is that it has events, right? It's not just page views. It's not just people viewing pages. We can actually fire events, custom events, just like we do to Mixpanel. And that is true. However, keep that in mind that events in GA are actually limited to about 3 or 4 event properties, you know, event action, event category, event label, those ones. The events in Mixpanel, on the other hand, are actually, I believe the limit's about 1,000 event properties. Now, you probably don't need 1,000, but between 3 and 1,000 is a big difference. And with our companies with tools like Mixpanel, the events that we design typically will have 10, 15, 20 event properties because we want to capture a lot of details, right? If we have a purchase, we want to track the amount, tax, shipping, category, user information, as much as possible. And that's where we get a lot of the data in, is through event properties. So we can use it, but it's really not the same. Now, let me take a quick pause here. If you're new to this channel, be sure to subscribe. I post content on a regular basis, whether it's technology breakdowns like we're doing here, or just workflows and how to get more out of your data. So you can just hit the red button there to subscribe. Make sure to turn on notifications, and let's go back to our regular video. GA also has this new type of feature, the web plus mobile property view, where you can combine some mobile information, like Firebase, and then merge it with web data. Mixpanel, by default, makes it quite easy to track cross-platform products. So whether you're mobile or web, we could track the same user across multiple products. GA historically couldn't do that really, really well. So the web plus mobile is actually quite nice. It's still in beta, and I think it would actually be a relatively good competitor. Right now, I would struggle to suggest it to clients and anyone who's really in production, especially fast growth companies. I think the features of that product itself are a little bit too limited right now. But in 6 months, 12 months, it might be a different question. Now, the last point here that I want to make, it's really pricing. The pricing is really quite different. GA is basically free for most companies, and then it kind of kicks up at about $150,000 a year for really high volume sites. But you could really have a few million visits a month in GA without any major issues. You know, you might run into sampling, but you could get around that by exporting the data. Mixpanel, on the other hand, has a free plan. It's really more of a testing plan, you know, see how it works. But the plans typically start about $100 a month, and they kind of go up with usage. In this case, users tracking, or what they call MTUs. Now, the final real point here is the bonus. That is, if Mixpanel is great for product teams or digital products, and really when I talk digital products, I really mean things that happen after a user signs up. And GA is great for market analysis. You can probably start to see that they're not really competitors, as really more supplementary to each other. And my ideal setup actually involves both. So I would typically recommend a company to have GA for anything to do with the marketing website and the marketing traffic, and basically track the user up to the point they sign up. So before they sign up, we may want to know what blog posts they're reading, how much time they're spending on the site, where are they coming from. This is all GA world, very classic, very straightforward. And the moment they sign up, we actually want to move to Mixpanel. And we want to then see, okay, are they completing the onboarding funnel? Are they switching? Let's say you have a cross-platform. Are they switching between web and mobile? Are they coming back to the product and using it? Retention. And as we release new features to the app, to the digital product, are users actually adopting them? This is all Mixpanel questions. So we can have a mix where you might have the marketing team rely primarily on GA, a little bit of Mixpanel, and you have the product team rely primarily on Mixpanel, maybe a little on GA, but you can start to see the split. And that's really how I would use both tools. And it does mean that one of them will likely be free, and the other one will have a paying cost to them, and that cost can go up depending on how much traffic or usage you have on your product itself. So that's all I have. I hope you enjoyed this video. Once again, my name is Ruben. Make sure to subscribe to the channel. I'll be posting regular content. Let me know what you think in the comments. And I'm also going to post a link to the Growth Needle. This is a weekly newsletter read by a few thousand people, I think, at this point. And I just get to share a few ideas, things that I'm learning from a client work, share resources, links. So I think you'll find that helpful. Make sure to find the link in the description. And my last question for you, hit the like button and let me know, how have you used GA and Mixpanel within your company? Did you find cool ways to sort of hack either tool to get more value out of it? Let me know. Talk soon.